Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Shreya Savijay. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 13th of July. India's PM Modi warns against overcrowding at tourist spots amid fears of third wave. Traders in Pakistan administered Kashmir hope redressal of grievances after election. And Sher Bahadur Deuba appointed as Nepal's Prime Minister after Oli resigns. And now for all the details. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Tuesday, while interacting with the chief ministers of seven northeastern states, urged them to step up measures to contain the spread of COVID-19 amid a high positivity rate and heavy influx of tourists from across India. He said the vaccination drive needs to be continuously ramped up to combat the third wave of the pandemic.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Tuesday warned against overcrowding at tourist sites and called for faster vaccinations against the coronavirus, even as official figures indicated a slower spread of new infections. Interacting with the chief ministers of eight northeastern states through video conferencing, Prime Minister Modi called for the greater emphasis on micro-containment zones to prevent a potential third wave of the pandemic. He noted that the COVID-19 situation is worrisome in some districts of the northeastern part of the country.
व्यापार, कारोबार, ये बहुत प्रभावित हुआ है। लेकिन आज मैं बहुत जोर देकर कहूँगा कि हिल स्टेशन में मार्केट्स में बिना मास्क पहने बिना प्रोटोकॉल का अमल किए बिना भारी भीड़ का उमड़ना मैं समझता हूं एक चिंता का विषय है ठीक नहीं है
India's coronavirus case load of 30.91 million infections is the world's second highest behind the United States On Tuesday, authorities reported 32,906 new cases, the lowest daily tally since mid-March, compared with some 400,000 a day at the height of the second wave. Modi called for vigilance against new variants of the virus and a faster campaign to get the population protected. The Indian Medical Association said on Monday it feared gathering of tourists and pilgrims could become super spreader events that fuel a deadly third wave of infections and it warned against complacency.
Rescue operations continued since early Tuesday in parts of India's Himachal Pradesh state after floods and massive landslides triggered by heavy rainfall hit the region, leaving behind a trail of destruction. At least two people were killed and nine others were missing due to the natural calamity till the last reports came in.
Rescue operations continued since early Tuesday in parts of Kangra district of India's northern Himachal Pradesh state after floods and massive landslides triggered by heavy rainfall hit the region on Monday. About 50 disaster management personnel and local responders had been deployed to look for survivors in the hard-hit Bow Valley in Kangra. At least two people were killed and nine others were missing in the flash floods, which destroyed homes, damaged roads and swept away cars. The fast-moving flood waters ripped away foundations of several buildings, forcing residents out on the streets in the rain.
हम बच गए हैं इसीलिए शुक्रिया अदा है इस मालिक का और बाकी हमारे घर में जो था वो कुछ भी नहीं रहा मेरी वाइफ प्रेग्नेंट है उसकी जान बचाने के चक्कर में बस हम सहमत रहे हमारा सामान कुछ भी नहीं रहा उसके अलावा और जो भी नुकसान दिख रहा है आपको दिख ही रहा है बताने की तो क्या जरूरत है बाकी ये जो हमारा रूम था यहां पे रेंट में रहते थे हम
रेस्क्यू वर्कर्स आल्सो कंडक्टेड ऑपरेशंस टू क्लियर रोड्स एंड रीस्टोर कनेक्टिविटी इन कुल्लू डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ हिमाचल प्रदेश फॉलोइंग लैंडस्लाइड्स ट्रिगर्ड बाय हेवी रेन Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi in a tweet said the situation in Himachal Pradesh is being closely monitored and all possible support is being extended. An alert has been sounded in the state for the next 5 days due to heavy rainfall, and general public has been advised to leave homes only for emergencies.
Moving on, traders in Pakistan-administered Kashmir have lamented that successive governments in the illegally occupied region have only exploited them over the years. They now expect the new government, which will be formed after the July 25 Assembly election, will address their long-standing issues, but they do not have high hopes. Traders in Pakistan-administered Kashmir have blamed that successive governments that work at Islamabad's behest have only exploited them over the years through their unjust policies. And politicians make hollow promises to bring about reforms ahead of elections, but all in vain. They blame that since 2005, when a deadly earthquake hit the region, there has been no development and no implementation of reforms for their welfare. And they were also completely ignored when the COVID-19 pandemic struck. They now expect the new government, which will be formed after the July 25 election, to provide them relief, but they do not have high hopes.
हम ये कहेंगे कि ये जो 2005 से आज 2021 हो गया, ये इतने अरसे में जो ताजर इस वक्त डिस्टर्ब है, उसको फौरी तौर पे आते साथ रिलीफ की सूरत में जो उनको बिला सूद कर्जा दिया जाए, उनको बिजली के बिलों में जो है वो सब्सिडी दी जाए। इसके साथ साथ जो हमारा सबसे बड़ा इस वक्त इशू है कि हमारे जो कमर्शियल किराए हैं।
Locals have long blamed that over 7 decades of Pakistan's illegal occupation has pushed Pakistan-administered Kashmir into the most neglected, backward and poorest area in the South Asian region. In news from Afghanistan, the Taliban has intensified attacks in several provincial capitals of Afghanistan in the last few weeks, raising concerns among residents. As Taliban insurgents and Afghan government forces battled for control of southern fringes of the capital city in Kunduz province, the acting governor has said more than 12,000 Afghan families have fled their homes in the province.
More than 12,000 Afghan families have fled their homes in Kunduz province as Taliban insurgents and government forces battled for control of the southern fringes of the capital city, the acting governor said on Monday. According to local media reports, Taliban militants have already captured most districts in Kunduz province, but are facing resistance from Afghan forces and armed civilians in and around the capital.
در ولایت قندوز ما به اثر جنگ های که صورت گرفت بالاتر از 12,000 فامیل خانه هایشان به جا شدند و بالاتر از 6,000 فامیل ما سروی کردیم یعنی آدمایی که واقعا مستحق بودند.
Displaced families living in tents in Kunduz city said they are in dire need of food and other relief. Recent territorial gains by the Taliban come as foreign troops led by the US military withdraw from Afghanistan after 20 years of war, leaving the task of pulling the country from a spiraling security crisis to local forces. On Monday, U.S. General leading the war in Afghanistan, Austin Miller, relinquished command at a ceremony and quietly left the country, a symbolic end to America's longest conflict, while Taliban insurgents gained momentum. President Joe Biden has set a formal end to the U.S. military mission for August 31 as he looks to disengage from a conflict triggered by Al-Qaeda's attacks on the United States on September 11, 2001.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Nepal's President Vidya Devi Bhandari on Tuesday appointed veteran liberal Sher Bahadur Deuba as the next Prime Minister of the Himalayan nation. This came a day after the country's apex court reinstated the parliament that was dissolved in May and approved Deuba's claim to the premiership, replacing KP Sharma Oli.
Nepal's President Bidya Devi Bhandari appointed veteran liberal Sher Bahadur Deuba as Prime Minister on Tuesday
a day after the Supreme Court reinstated the parliament that was dissolved in May. 75-year-old Deoba, head of the centrist Nepali Congress Party, will head a coalition with former Maoist rebels and a party representing a minority community dominant on Nepal's southern plains, the latest development in a months-long political crisis that left the country without a parliament. Deoba has served as Prime Minister four times in the past. He will now have to win a vote of confidence in parliament next month. The Supreme Court on Monday ordered Deoba to be appointed in place of K.P. Sharma Oli, who had failed to win a vote of confidence and dissolved parliament twice in recent months, which the court ruled was unconstitutional. The new leader's immediate task will be to procure COVID-19 vaccines and control the coronavirus spread that has infected more than 658,000 people and killed nearly 10,000 of them. More than 1.3 million people have had first dose of COVID-19 vaccine and are awaiting a second shot as the government scrambles to protect its people.
In Pakistan's commercial capital, Karachi, it's time for an annual spectacle as the Muslim festival of Eid al-Adha is fast approaching. Ahead of the sacrificial festival, plump and polished cattle are lowered by crane from Karachi resident Syed Ejaz Ahmed's rooftop farm down into a congested street, attracting huge crowds to witness the event. The Muslim festival of Eid al-Adha, or the Feast of Sacrifice, is fast approaching, and in this neighborhood in Pakistan's commercial capital Karachi, it's time for an annual spectacle. Every year, plump and polished cattle are lowered by crane from Syed Ejaz Ahmed's rooftop farm down into a congested street of the Nazimabad neighborhood ahead of the sacrificial festival. This year, the festival takes place for 3 days next week from July 21. An excited crowd jostles to see a white ox weighing more than 500 kg hanging by straps as it is carefully lowered from the top of the four-story building this past weekend.
छोटे से बच्चे लेके हम लेकर आते हैं और इसको पालते हैं छत पे ना जीने के जरिए चढ़ाते हैं उसके बाद ये माशाल्लाह बड़े हो जाते हैं जब बड़े हो जाते हैं तो ये जीने से उतर नहीं सकते फिर इसके लिए हमें क्रेन हायर करनी पड़ती है.
People usually buy sacrificial animals for slaughter a few days before Eid, but Ahmed decided to build a barn on his rooftop and raise his own. It has proved to be a much more economical choice for the small business owner, even though he has to hire a crane. This year, Ahmed selected 5 oxen and 1 cow for the festival, which is one of the 2 most important ones in the Islamic calendar. The meat will be shared among family and friends and also donated to the poor. The famous Jagannath Chariot Festival kicked off in India's eastern Puri city on Monday while adhering to COVID-19 protocols. The annual event usually witnesses participation of millions of devotees, but this year, only temple priests and management officials with COVID-19 negative report and who have been fully vaccinated were allowed to take part.
The famous Jagannath Chariot Festival began in Puri city of India's eastern Odisha state on Monday amid restrictions due to COVID-19 outbreak. The ceremonial event marks the journey of Hindu Lord Jagannath, his brother Balbhadra and sister Subhadra from the 12th century Jagannath temple to their maternal aunt's house situated at the Gundija temple, some 2 miles away. The 90 event usually witnesses participation of millions of devotees, but this year only temple priest and the management who tested negative for COVID-19 and were fully vaccinated were allowed to take part amid concerns of virus spread.
और भगवान जी के अपार कृपा से इस साल हमको भगवान जी का सेवा करने का मौका मिला है रथ यात्रा में और हम प्रभु के प्रार्थना करते हैं अगले साल प्रभु को रथयात्रा सब भक्तजनों के साथ समागम हो और सब भक्तजन को मिले सुविधा जो कि रथयात्रा में भाग ले सके.
Devotees pulled 3 decorated wooden chariots towards Gundija temple, carrying the deities with thick ropes amid beating drums and chanting of hymns. The idols are placed in the temple and then chariot return is held after 8 days.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.